The focus of today's war strategy, speak from the heart. And the scripture would be 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 12. And it says, for our rejoicing is this, the testimony of our conscience, that in simplicity and godly sincerity, not with fleshy wisdom, but by the grace of God, we have had our conversation in the world and more abundantly to you ward. Let us pray. Father, today you're calling many of us to the battlefields. You're calling many of us to go forth and begin to preach and to teach your word. For Father, if there's one thing that has been happening in the churches today, is that the people with the well-trained tongues who could speak in an intellectual conversation, who could speak an intellectual word and be gifted in public speaking, these are the ones in which people has been putting on a high platform and considering to be the example as to what the body of Christ ought to be if they wish to be preachers in your church, if they wish to be teachers in your church, if they wish to be leaders in your church. But Father, what is happening is that we are taking the fleshy wisdom of man and taking their charisma, their charismatic way of presenting your gospel message and making that to be the standard as to how the sheep is to be led. But Lord, when we go to your scripture, we see a completely different story in regards to Paul's the message of Paul and what he had addressed to the Corinthian church. For Father, what he had addressed in this scripture is in complete conflict. Is in complete conflict and a complete opposition, Father, as to what we see in the churches today. Because while the churches are promoting fleshy wisdom, which means cunning conversations and ways of using different techniques and style of speaking a word to tickle the ears of the people, Paul is saying that instead, he rejoices. He rejoices in the testimony of his conscience, because Paul used to be a Pharisee, Father. He used to be a Pharisee before you, and you have allowed it to be so for the purpose as to what you would bring him out of into a greater thing that you desire for him to do in the church. And so what happened is that Paul used to be a person who was very keen and great in fleshy wisdom. And so in fleshy wisdom, Father, is the way in which he carried out his office as a Pharisee, which produced no fruit to the kingdom of God. But then he was delivered from that, Father. You deliver him in that Damascus Road experience. And as a result of that Damascus Road experience, he was able to leave behind a fleshy wisdom, Father, the fleshy wisdom that was not producing your kingdom fruits, oh God, that was not converting people onto salvation, but rather was leading many people to hell. And so, Father, when we see this example that Paul was a Pharisee and that he was using much fleshy wisdom, which kept the people in bondage, what is happening in today's church today, Father? How many people are still being kept in bondage in religious spirits because of the fleshy wisdom of those who say that they are called by your name, but yet they go to the pulpits, they go to different platforms, it doesn't matter who they be, they go and they preach a message of man's wisdom, but they don't preach the message of the power of the cross. They don't preach the message, Father, of what you've done for us on the cross, of how you delivered us and set us free from sin, oh God. And so as a result, there is a great grief that is upon your heart, because the people are still in bondage and they have not shaken out of their positions, their situations from the time of the Pharisees, oh God, when many were under that bondage as well. But we thank you so much, Father, for setting us free, oh God, for coming down and righting the wrong, for correcting the things that has been lacking, oh God, in which you have set many people free from the prison cells, oh God. When those who were sitting in these religious spirits, Father, these religious positions of authority would not let the captives free. We thank you so much, Father, for breaking us free from these religious spirits and for helping us to identify that that one of the key factors, Father, of the pharisaical system was the fact that they had fleshy wisdom. And because of the fleshy wisdom, the people perish. And so today in a churches, Father, many are presenting fleshy wisdom of man. And so the people still perishes. The reason why many people are not coming into churches today, Father, is because they don't see any power in the church anymore. When they see the churches today, Father, and the mess in which they are making it, Father, they see it no different than the pharisaical houses, the Pharisees. house father of your time. And so what Paul has come to the conclusion was, Father, is that he was once a man, Father, of fleshy wisdom. But then he had the Damascus Road experience where you had to drastically intervene in his life to save him, to save his soul. And then once you was able to save him, you was able to really to introduce him to the real message, the gospel message. And what Paul has come to learn, Father, is the same principle that we must all come to learn, is that we don't need to be people with educated speech, well eloquent in words, oh God, to be able to stand as your preachers and teachers, Father, in the ministry today. But rather, Paul says that he rejoices in the fact that there was a testimony of his conscience. And we know, Father, that what you taught us about the conscience, Father, is about the morality of who we are. It's about the morality of what is right and what is wrong. And so he was rejoicing at the fact that in his conscience, he knew to do the morally right thing. And that in his conscience, he was able to do the morally right thing, despite of what many people had believed or what many people had thought about his messages. And so he was rejoicing by the fact that he was in the right standing with you. How many of us today, Father, are not in the right standing with you, Father, because instead of taking on the testimony of our conscience, which is the morality of doing what is right over what is doing what is wrong, we take on the fleshy wisdom of this world, oh God, and create the spiritual Pharisee system that is keeping many people in bondage and in lack today in the churches. And so the sheep are being fleeced right now, Father, by those who are supposed to be their shepherds, but they're getting fat off the sheep. All the sheep are unprotected, oh God, and are being devoured by the enemy, Father, and they are helpless right now, Father. And so this day, Father, you are raising up a people, oh God, who are willing to rejoice and understand the power of having the testimony of a conscience, the testimony of being morally right before you. For these are the people you are seeking, and this is who Paul was, oh God, is that Paul was a man who was who come to understand having the testimony of a morally right conscience before you when preaching the gospel. And then once he came to the morally right concept and understanding of what it meant to be your ambassador, what it meant to be your apostle, what it meant to be an evangelist before you, he went on to say, Father, that it is with the simplicity and the godly sincerity that he was able to present the gospel. It's by the simplicity, godly sincerity, and the grace in which you provided, in which he was able to go and be a preacher, to be an apostle, to be a teacher of the gospel. And so these are the three principal factors, Father, that you're telling us today that we need to be qualified for the call, is that we must have the testimony, Father, of a clean conscience before you, and that our hearts are set before you in a godly and sincere way. For this is what it means to be to have godly sincerity. It means to speak with sincerity, and the only way we can speak with sincerity is not through fleshy wisdom, but it's when we speak your word from our hearts, oh God. And so you're calling us today to be people who would be those who would speak from the heart. And so if we have the moral, the testimony of a conscience, of a clean conscience, of a moral conscience, and the godly sincerity of our heart, oh God, and in the willingness to present the simplicity of the gospel of what you have done for us on the cross and how you set us free, if we are willing to take on these three pillars in our lives, oh God, then you couple it all together and you perfect it by your grace. For it says, Father, by the grace of God, we have had our conversation in the world. So what this means, Father, is when we take on these three principles, once again, Father, you taught us, Father, that when we take on the principle of a clean heart, of a sincere heart, speaking from the heart with a clean conscience of doing the morally right thing, and also for presenting the simplicity of the gospel, which is not confusing, which does not cause any kind of intellectual debates, but the simple truth, then we can rest assured, Father, that even in our most simplicity of messages, in our most simple of sermons, in our most simple of words, your grace will move in and amplify it, oh God. And we know this to be true because we saw the fruits of Paul that he produced when he was a Pharisee under fleshy wisdom, and the fruits that he produced when he was an apostle saved under your grace. And so we pray this day, Father, that you would begin to start raising up the people who knows, Father, what is the right thing to do, who sees the damage of the churches, oh God, who sees the wrong things that has happened, who sees the people who are being hurt, who are being led astray, who are being held in bondage, oh God. We pray that you would begin to start raising up your voices who have the clean conscience, oh God, who have the godly sincerity of their hearts, oh God, who have the simple gospel message upon their lips. And may you increase their faith to know that if they are willing to step boldly, Father, and present the simple gospel message in which Paul was able to present the simple gospel message to the people, that you will couple it with grace and you shall produce wonders through them, oh God. And so we pray, Father, that this will be the time of great signs and wonders as the people go forth in faith and in boldness and knowing that they have the clean conscience, they have the testimony of a clean conscience which you have given them, that they have the godly sincerity to have passion and love for the people, to go out there and minister to them, and to have the simplicity of the gospel of the message that you have taught us and which even the babe can understand, and that we can start bringing in a mighty harvest, and that revivals will begin to start breaking out throughout the four corners of the globe. We thank you so much for hearing our prayers, and we thank you so much, Father, for activating this war strategy to your glory. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.